Every Thursday, right here, every woman, every man, and their dog.
Bentley only goes
that's
for the woman.
Bentley, that's Hayden.
Meet for a brew.
Usual Thursday morning order.
And a brouhaha.
We have our coffee and correct things that are going on around the world.
But lately, the conversation has centred on a local mystery.
What's in it?
You tell us.
Tell us.
They can't quite agree on when it started.
I've noticed it in the last 2 years, maybe.
Mainly in the mornings, I think, isn't it?
No, just quite a few in the evening as well, Billy.
The power's been going off and on for the last 10 years.
Luckily, Margaret has a long list of dates.
23rd of June.
I think.
27th of June.
You.
12th of July.
Get.
2nd of August.
The.
3rd of August. 6th of September.
Just.
4th of October and 6th of October.
This is a village, a community, with a power problem.
Come back on up to 3 times, 4 times.
And a power problem affects everyone.
We have been taken for granted by the power company. The power's off all the time and they're blaming this and that.
It's not just power cuts, it's what happens after the outages to a very important item in the household.
Something there.
Hello, my friend. It's morning, time to wake now.
Welcome to Pisa Moorings, just 5 minutes from Cromwell. Very nice place to drive around, home to around 1,500 people. The local power supplier is Aurora Energy, owned by the Dunedin City Council. It supplies power to Central Otago, Dunedin, and to Pisa Moorings, Karen Culling. Karen wants to show you her vast collection of broken modems.
I'm probably the only one that's actually kept them all. That's the first one. That's the second one. And I don't know, the third one must have been thrown out.
So, why so many modems?
Because every time we have a power cut, they keep shitting themselves, frying.
She's on her fourth one and is well over it.
Can't check your emails, can't pay your bills, can't do anything because you don't have any internet to do anything.
She could use her phone, but reception isn't great. And the peculiar thing is, it's only Spark modems. And yes, she's tried a surge protector.
We did have a surge protector on our thing, on our modem, and it's still fried.
Down the road, Hazel was on security while Toby's getting a touch-up.
Good boy.
Annette Norgrove's a dog groomer.
That's 2 shampoos. Conditioner's next. Yeah, nothing but the best.
Her dog bath is a hub for community news.
Good boy. They'd come in for dog grooms and you get a snapshot of people's life every couple of months. And they'll tell me, oh, you know, another modem's fried, I'm on my third.
Especially after the night of October 5th.
That was the big one where I'd say upward of 40 modems probably fried.
Annette took to Facebook.
I asked on the community page and it seems everybody's had an issue. A spark, no one else.
But no one has any idea of the why.
No, I don't think that's why we called you.
Annette says their power has been flicking on and off for too long.
This has been going on at least 18 months.
I can't work if the power goes off.
Here we go. Look how I feel about it. Pretty pissed off, to be honest.
Ian Kemp is on his third modem. He's mad because Spark refused to give him a free warranty replacement.
Cut a long story short, the manager there says, no, you cannot have any more because you already had one under the warranty scheme.
And Spark modems are not cheap.
New one was $106.
Which leaves them worried about next time.
But what happens in the future? What if we get another power surge? Who's paying again, you know?
Ian's final problem is, every time there's a power cut, he has to drive to Spark's store for a replacement. That's 50 minutes to Queenstown, or 40 to Alexandra. Often he'll call ahead to find out they've already run out.
I think they've all got their heads in the sand, Spark and the local power company.
The power problem doesn't just affect people's modems. Andrew left me his sizzled television.
Guess I'll go this way. Come over here.
I think it's time you met Lynn Price.
This is the second one.
She's on her third modem, but we aren't here to talk about that.
I've got to make sure I get it the right way.
Hideous.
You see, Lynn.
And I'm good.
Has other issues, bigger issues.
I've got motor neurons disease. No cure for it whatsoever. My sister had it as well. She passed away after, I think it was 12 months.
Which means when Lynn goes to bed, she worries.
I lose a lot of oxygen when I sleep, so my oxygen levels go dangerously low.
What supplements her breathing is this oxygen pump. What keeps the pump going is electricity.
Later on, it will be a matter of probably life or death.
Which means?
I do worry about the pay cuts.
It was time to take the telly and some modems to an expert.
Like pretty much most electronics these days, reasonably cheap to manufacture, reasonably expensive to repair.
Craig Stephen has been fixing electronics for easily 35 years.
Likely thing is with a power spike as it sizzles this thing.
His first stop was the power adapter.
And we got a good 12 volts on the display there.
Next was getting inside. Mass-produced modems aren't designed to be opened and repaired.
Bingo. Look at that.
And Craig says a spark modem...
I've got pretty much proprietary chips in there.
...has many parts designed specifically for one job.
Here we go. Here's the working part here.
Which means it could be a straightforward problem.
It could be something as simple as it's just glitched all the programming inside it.
But after a look and a poke...
So I'd say it's some sort of logic fault.
The results are sadly inconclusive.
There's no way of knowing without actually doing a serious autopsy on the thing.
Aurora Energy, who is in charge of the power supply, like going on television to talk about new projects.
The advantages of the submarine cables is that it was actually the lowest cost option.
They also make bright and shiny marketing videos.
We are powering your home.
But when it comes to fronting up and explaining supply problems to a community losing power and not knowing why, they sent us some words. Aurora Energy say since 2020 they have had 35 power cuts at Pisa Moorings, including 12 unplanned outages this year. And the biggest reason for all of these disruptions is equipment faults. They also tell us they're spending $500 million on the network over 5 years, including later this month, 2 days of work at Pisa Moorings, including 19 new power poles. And they're going to install a voltage logger, which will help them figure out what's causing the power cuts. But the answer to Aurora Energy's current problems is in its history. In 2020, Aurora was fined $5 million for breaching network quality standards through an excessive level of power outages. The Commerce Commission said Aurora was well aware of its deteriorating network, but failed to take action. And just a few days ago, Aurora was warned again. And for those dying modems, Spark is currently investigating the cause, but warns modems damaged by electricity surges aren't covered by warranty.
I keep meaning to throw them out, but I thought no.
You may have guessed by now, Karen tells it like it is. She's...
pissed off.
It's the little things, like setting up her internet 4 separate times.
You got to put your password in.
And also the big things, like knowing you're going to wake up the next morning.
I'm very lucky.
Aurora Energy says it's keen to meet the locals.
Where do you want to sit?
It's random.
They'll get their chance if they get a word in.
Got the dog.
At the next coffee group.
We're the ones that suffer.